almost silence until Edward threw that right leg kick. So intense are the audience here.
That's one of the main differences you see in the Asian communities versus the United States, when there's a little bit of a, not necessarily a lull in the action, but the Asian communities, in Japan especially, they tend to be very quiet during the fights. They really respect what's going on, not only the martial arts aspect of it, but from the fighter's standpoint. Here in the USA, people are just much more rowdy.
Another good long right hand there a moment ago from Enomoto.
Both guys taking the first minute and a half here to feel each other out, gauge that distance. Ooh, nice right hand, and it followed up with a nice leg kick.
And then the left hand came in as well, and another kick. Using his left leg there to damage the right side of Enomoto.
We talked about earlier, you know, guys from the same gyms tend to almost emulate each other. Yeah. They're striking or they're grappling and knocking heads. So all the Team Lakai guys, very similar how they mix up their straight punches, their angles, throwing those kicks from different angles. And the more comfortable that Folayang feels like he is here, another nice shot to the ribs, the more he's going to be able to open up with his arsenal.
Enomoto's stance is high-handed, as I said before. That right hand is close to the face, but it's an open defense he has. It's not tight by any means.
Folayang really throws it hard. You can sit near Kane's side, these punches that are missing are just a couple of inches off of breaking cinder blocks. And Enomoto is doing a really good job, too, of, you know, gauging his distance and working that jab. He wants to really exploit that distance that he has, letting Folayang get inside and work the body. Isn't the way to win this fight.
Really super left jab from Folayang a moment ago.
Good kick.
Catching Enomoto just to the side of the left eye.
You know, typically when you see guys that have a lightning fast spinning back kick,
he does that a lot, and he'll also throw a spinning punch as well. He did that quite a lot against Larson, and I have to say, not to good effect with the punch. The spinning kick can do some damage, and has done.
Well, you know, if this becomes a brawl, I think it's going to favor Edward Folayang, because when we saw him and Larson, I mean, that was just back and forth action, and it really showed that both these guys can take a big punch.
Took a good left hand from Enomoto and gave him a little nod of appreciation as well.
You know, I think Enomoto is still having a difficult time finding his range here. He hasn't really landed anything on Folayang. It's been too detrimental. I really like to see him work that jab a little more, since he, as you pointed out, he has a reach advantage. If nothing else, he can use that to see what Folayang's game plan is going to be.
Jab to the body, I always think is a dangerous way to attack, but Folayang does it so quickly there, doesn't really give Felipe much chance to come back at him. And there's a right-left-right combination.
A great movement. A nice 1-2 by Enomoto, just took him off balance a little bit.
Approaching the final minute of this opening round.
Folayang works the body a lot like Mike Tyson does. He just kind of sits down and he throws those 2-3 body shots and puts his hips really nicely behind it. You know, body shots won't necessarily knock you out, but it's a nice kick, but it just really breaks down your wind. Messes up your breathing pattern. Enomoto's a little stiff boxing. He's got good movement, he's flicking that jab out there, but yeah, his combinations, he's been throwing with his head up.
Yes, I agree.
Again, having a hard time getting in that range, because every time he gets close, he gets 3 or 4 from Folayang.
There is a bit of a contrast there. You say that Enomoto's a bit stiff, but Folayang moves so well, doesn't he? Very fluid,
right,
both
yeah.
hands.
Yeah, well, I think Enomoto's just really having a hard time setting up his timing, really. And the range is there. Folayang's with precision getting in and out with his punches.
Kick to the rib cage there for Folayang as this first round comes to a close. And probably the Colt 45. And a good right hand from Folayang. Follows it up with a few more. The left hand caught Enomoto as well. Doesn't seem overly perturbed by it. Takes the center ring.
Folayang, I would say, out of all the Team Lakai guys that I've seen fight, probably has the best wrestling defense. He's shown some very good takedown defense. I mean, not as much in this fight, because there's only been one, you know, discernible takedown attempt, but he fought off a couple good attempts from Ole Larson, and again, super quick. Once Folayang gets inside, he's able to unleash his combinations.
Oh, left and right hand from Eduard.
Just like that, he's able to mix up the angles well. Enomoto is still sticking with those 1-2s.
Yeah, it perhaps is the fluidity of Eduard's punches that may gain him the edge. Can just move that little bit quicker and come in from a slightly more bigger variety of angles. Perhaps Enomoto a little bit predictable. Oh, and two-handed attack from the Filipino again. The crowd roar, and that was a solid right hand. Follows it up with a very stiff jab. He's taken big punches, but you can't really say that Enomoto has been rocked yet. He's been pushed back.
You know, and the ironic part is that he's been moving forward the whole fight, and it's very difficult. There's only a handful of guys that are successful counterpunchers, like Folayang is moving backwards.
These two really well matched. It's a very absorbing contest. The right hand's coming in from Eduard again. He's having a super round.
It's a good chopping leg kick.
Big kick, wasn't it? Folayang has tree trunk-like legs, though.
See, Enomoto's just overextending himself on that cross. If someone throws it right, it's not straight down the center. He's coming off his base a lot. It's a nice right kick. But Folayang's able to come back and counter and beat him to those punches. I really would like to see Enomoto use that jab more. Kind of clawing right hand there.
But he's really targeting that left leg of Folayang, isn't he?
I think that's smart. I mean, so far, Folayang hasn't had an answer for it. He's connected with three of his last three.
As Enomoto came in there, he got caught with a short left. The amount of times that Eduard spins round in a contest, I don't think I've seen any fighter do that quite so much. Left and right.
That jab came in and just landed right on the chin.
Really got the bit between his teeth now, Folayang.
Nice side kick. And Folayang, just, he puts everything out there with intent. Even his jabs are hard. Boy, I tell you, if we could just go slow motion on Folayang's face, you can see that he just has intent behind every one of those punches.
Look at Enomoto coming forward the whole time, despite the barrage that he receives, the heavy punches that he's eating.
Well, I think that it's smart, too, because by coming forward, it's you don't really want Folayang coming forward on you, right? I mean, that's what happens. So, well, they're keeping him on his toes. I just think he needs to mix the game up.
Tremendously aggressive from Eduard. He takes a punch early so as to open up his opponent and then comes in with the counter and then just doesn't stop.
Just missed that right hand.
It's a mark under Enomoto's right eye.
Yeah, Enomoto's just throwing that 1-2 out there again, not really turning his hands over too much. Sorry, turning his hips over too much on those kicks either.
Is furious here. What an entertaining contest this is.
Flying did a good job there, stuffing the shot.
1 minute left in the second round.
You see, Flying has good instincts. He knows when Enomoto's inside of the shot, and he needs to make his number one priority to peel him up there and to fight that hand grip and head placement. He's not trying to reach over him or throw anything crazy to knock him out while he's getting the takedown. He knows that that's the immediate threat. He has to fight.
Enomoto comes in with that jab and has to take really big punches from Eduard. There it is. Not all of them land.
Oh, that was a good shot. Big
right hand, and Enomoto goes down and now takes the barrage of punches.
There's a finisher
coming from Enomoto's nose. The punches still come down.
I don't know if he's going to have enough time here with 15 seconds left. He's got to be careful he doesn't get caught with an armbar here by throwing those punches.
Just able to survive. He's got 10 seconds left in the second round. The crowd are on their feet at cage side. Hammer blows from Folayang. It's not going to be enough. Which is brought to you by Colt 45, knowing that he's got to do something pretty special.
Well, there's definitely the sense of urgency now. I mean, you're 10 minutes into a 15-minute fight. The takedown hasn't really been there for you. The punches, you've been getting the short end of the stick on. So this is where you need to start.
Oh, reversal. Good shot from Enomoto. A shower of sweat and moisture came off Folayang's head. And you heard the slapping sound here, cage side.
You know, if Enomoto put together a couple more combinations, I think he could open up that shot more down Folayang, but he's just throwing 1-2 and he's backing off because Folayang's coming in there. It's just like that, he threw 1-2. And sometimes he's connecting with that because of the extra reach, but anytime he's tried to really put together a bigger combination, Folayang's gotten better inside.
I'm trying to get a good look at this. I think Enomoto is bleeding from the nose. He keeps pawing at it as well. Blood's not streaming down,
but Enomoto, you know, to his credit, still has a lot of gas left in the tank. You can tell he's
light
on his
well.
Feet.
Yeah. In fact, he's looking a little bit more fluid than he has done in the first two rounds, where we both remarked that he was a little bit stiff. Edward nearly stumbled there again after that spinning kick that he likes to employ.
Well, Edward Folayang is definitely a difficult guy to take down. And it's smart, you know, he plays to his strengths. Obviously, in mixed martial arts, you want to train everywhere, but if primarily you're a striker.
Left and right from Eduard.
Tuning up that wrestling to help keep the fight where you want, it's going to be key.
Oh, that was a big head maker. It wasn't really anywhere near the target. But it just shows how much energy Eduard has. He's really fit for the three round of 5-minute contest. Oh, and he took a big right hand there when he was off balance and stayed up.
It's hard to tell if he was more off balance because he's holding the kick or if that really rocked him. Nice jab.
It's Eduard coming forward now. In the second round, we saw Felipe Enomoto inching forward. He puts everything into his punches, Folayang. Sometimes they perhaps lack a little bit of finesse, but when he lands, he really lands.
Yeah, he swings to the fence, there's no doubt about that. He's not trying to win a point scoring contest.
Just took that big stiff left jab from Enomoto and brings the knee up as well. The Japanese fighter spends much of his time in Switzerland. He has his own gym, works very hard with his brother.
You know, Felipe Enomoto, he's very tough. I mean, this guy has fought a few different UFC bets, so he knows what it's like to be in there with high-level guys. Fought Rich Clemente back in 2010, completely different fighter than Edward Folayang is, but, you know, so that wealth of experience that other guys have had in there, he knows how to weather storms and see those openings.
These two have been in each other's faces since the start. They're not giving any ground.
Now, there's one thing we learned from the fight he had with Ole Larson, that you really can't count that one out, because this fight looked almost identical with Ole.
Sure. He pulled that one out the back, didn't he?
Pulled it out the back, zipped it up, sealed it. It was over.
And he just caught Edward as Edward was going back with a nice cheeky little left hand to the chin. There goes the kick to the inside of Folayang's left thigh. 54 seconds left in the final round. And the crowd here making a bit of noise, knowing that if things continue to go this way, their man, Eduard Folayang, has a very good chance of coming away with a decision. But while Enomoto's standing and throwing punches, anything could happen. How are the judges viewing this? Looking at the fight as a whole, not round by round, remember. Two great athletes, Jiff's giving absolutely everything. Not once have they tried to take a breather, and Enomoto goes down. Open attack single by the referee. Enomoto with his hands behind his head. We're in the final 10 seconds, and you figure not a great deal's going to happen in that time. But down goes Eduard. One last flash of him, but he got kicked back and had to retreat. That's the end of the fight. And both men show the respect that you always knew they would.
The winner, by unanimous decision, in the red.